Hey, Brett McFall here. And if you want to take your folks on a journey like I've been teaching you, then why don't I help you out even further and actually step by step the whole thing for you? Would that make it easy? All right, I hear you saying yes. Okay. Because what I'm going to do here is I'm actually going to, again, in a flowchart, tell you what to do and when to do it. And I'll keep it nice and easy as well, and because it doesn't need to be very hard. What I've worked out is, you know, simpler is better. And so I'm going to flowchart that for you right now. So get ready to take notes, get ready to think, because this would change your presentation dramatically. It's one thing to teach you how to do it, but if I just show you, here are the steps, just do this, this, and this, then I know A, you'll get excited, but then B, it means if you're excited about it, you'll want to go and do it for your presentation and start and change things up, all right? Now remember this, before I take you to the computer and teach you this, it's not about how intelligent you are or about showing the audience how intelligent you are. That is not what what the purpose of your presentation is. Your purpose is to educate in the simplest possible way so that your audience follows you, gets excited with you, and can see your vision, okay? If you want to impress them with how intelligent and how much information you have in your head, then do that in your coaching program. In this one, it's about starting that relationship and helping you know, your audience come on the journey with you. So it's an exciting thing. Get this right, and you really are setting yourself up for big sales on the end, all right? Let's go to my computer, and I will show you, step by step it out, in the flowchart, how to do it, all right? Let's go. Now we take them into the journey section, okay? The journey section, so write this down. You'll see here I've written secret number one, and then the letters S, L, E in the boxes below. So you make sure you write down the same. Now I'm going to explain what this is. What I've found is that in a 90-minute presentation, you really can only effectively cover three secrets, okay? Now, if you can also cover more, you can, but you can't give as much value within each. You have to speed through them. Now, I've given away seven secrets, five secrets, three secrets, and I found that three secrets allows you to give each secret the attention it deserves. So, why am I talking about secrets? Because we're going to have secret one, two, and three. Why am I talking secrets? Firstly, people love secrets. We all love secrets. So you want to come into this presentation to sell your product, your service, for sure. But you cannot sell until you've given some value. All right, that's the order. We give first, we ask for the sale later. We must give value first. And this is what this section, this journey is all about, where we help take our viewer, our audience on a journey so they can actually get some value from what we've just, from sitting in front of our presentation. We want to give them stuff they can take away. They should be able to take notes and be able to say, right, that was good, that was good, that was good. That's the experience we need them to have. The reason why is we want them to be excited. We don't want them to be overwhelmed, and we won't overwhelm them if you do what I'm going to tell you to do, but we do want them to be excited about A, the future, about what can be achieved, but B, about you and about the fact that you have just taken them on this journey, all right? Now, three secrets. You're going to need to find three things you can teach your audience. Something which they may or may not know. Even if they do know it, it's okay, but you're going to present it as something very important so they can be sitting there going, yeah, I know that. That just reconfirms what I was believing, etc. You know, so it doesn't have to be something completely weird and out of this world. It can just be three really powerful secrets that are, when you hear them, when you see them, you feel like, yeah, that's common sense. I agree. That really does make sense, okay? So then you might ask, well, what is the SLE mean? What does this mean? You'll see here below each secret, I've got the letters SLE. Now let me tell you what they're for. S represents story. Story, okay? You want to be able to tell the very first thing. So as you say, as you start to teach them the first secret, the first thing you want to do is you want to tell the audience a story. Because people, we, you, me, love stories. It's all about the story. And so few people tell stories in their presentations, okay? So the story doesn't have to be your story. It can be and should be if you've absolutely got it. But if you don't have a story, it can also be someone else's story. What it's meant to do is highlight the importance of this secret, okay? The story highlights the importance of this secret, but it allows people to be able to remember something. What will happen is that when you finish your presentation, your audience, the things they will remember most will be the stories. They may not remember the focus questions or what your credibility was or the barrier that's in the way, but they will remember the stories that you tell. This is really, really powerful. So you've got to find a story. The first thing you tell them is the story to highlight the importance of that secret. And then you go into the next section, which is the L. The L stands for lesson, okay? That's where we start and teach some things. So we've told your audience a story that highlights the importance of secret number one, or, you know, proves it, or something like that. Then we're going to teach them a lesson. So here we're going to give them some tips and advice. You know, general stuff like do this, do that, or, you know, special keys to, or special secrets of, or special tips for. Teach them about what that secret is so they can go home. Firstly, they can actually take notes and actually go home and do it. That's the key. Stuff they can actually take away. And then the E stands for example. All right, so the three letters stand for story, lesson, example. The example is where you start and give hypotheticals for their situation. So you actually have a little headline saying, here's how this applies to you. Here is how this will apply to you. And then you start and give some examples. So if this was a presentation, you know, even right now in this presentation, you know, I might say, well, if you are an author, here's how this applies. If you are an information marketer, here's how this applies. If you are a business owner, here's how you could use whatever's taught you. So you give examples that help the audience out. You're going to give them examples about them. You're doing most of the thinking for them at this point, okay? You're doing the thinking for them. You've told them a story which gets them excited, interested in the concept of secret number one. You've taught them a lesson so they can actually write some things down, techniques, strategies, things like that. And then the example is all about them. So you tell them what they can do if you were in their shoes. Give them more examples. Give them things. Well, if you could do this, you could do this, you could do that. All right, and that is truly powerful. SLE makes every secret come alive, makes it exciting, makes it educational, and makes you look like someone that they can trust because you've given freely, okay? So you can't hold back in these. You have to give freely. You have to give freely. You don't overwhelm with data and specifics and technicals and all that sort of stuff, but you do give freely. And always talk about the benefits, the benefits, the benefits. That's what people love, all right? All right, now, what comes after this? What comes after this is a section called the real opportunity, where now you've taught them, they feel satisfied. At this point, you're probably at least at the 60-minute mark, right? And now you want to talk about the real opportunity. You could be at between the 60-minute mark and, say, the 75-minute mark. Anywhere there will be fine. But the real opportunity now exists. So, you know, now that I've taught you this, let me tell you about the real opportunity that exists. So you can now tell them, you're here and you now understand so much more now that you've been through my presentation, but there's a massive opportunity out there. Paint the picture of the opportunity that's available to them, which means, you know, is there a certain type of market which they can go after? Are there certain savings that can be made? Are there certain problems that can be fixed? Are there certain solutions that can be taken advantage of? Does that make sense? Okay, the real opportunity that is available to our viewer. The real opportunity, which means something they can then take advantage of now they understand what you're talking about, all right? And from this point, then we move into the opportunity section. Now, before I do that, I'm going to come back to the process in just a minute. But here's a case study of how powerful this system is. I want you to meet this lady. Her name is Judy Jakes, a 56-year-old grandmother, ex-nurse, and seven-day-a-week tour operator here in the Gold Coast where I live in Australia. She was running a tour bus that took you out to wineries, her and her husband, every single day. So very, very busy. She's got lots of experience, but she came to one of my trainings wanting more, wanting a different way through. So she had a choice. She could either continue to slog it out all day or change her methods, and she chose to change her methods. And I showed her how to take what was in her brain and turn it into a powerful program, but also how to sell it via a presentation. So she had also been earning a side income online using affiliate marketing. So I showed Judy how to create a 90-minute presentation, just like I'm showing you, that offered a way for prospects to learn how to do what she did. All right, she wanted to coach them in her way of affiliate marketing. Now, she didn't know what to do, but I told her exactly what to do, exactly what to say. She's now done over $4 million in sales of her coaching program. $4 million using my method of presenting, right? My what I call my 90-minute marketer system. And so because of the order of the presentation, because of the way she does it, over $4 million in sales. and still continuing on. Literally has changed her life forever. She now has a skill, at the very, very least, has a skill she can use anytime she wants. Anytime she wants to sell something, she simply plugs it into my presentation system and she knows she can sell it at a high rate. All right, isn't that cool? All right.